we're actually missing this piece on the bump, on the fender. Let me get this tab off. Put it back right here. So line it up right there. The headlights lined up. The brackets lined up underneath the headlight. Like that. This is lined up. And underneath the semi lined up. So we're gonna put bolts on top first. But we're not going to screw it down. The screw right here. So what I'm going to do first, is I'm going to put the hood down and see the alignment, make sure it's lined up correctly. So here's the gap. We'll check out the other gap on the other side just to make sure it's the same way. Same way. So this gap goes a little bit narrower on this on the top side, and it looks like it's narrow on that side. So the gap looks proper to me. So lift up the hood back up. I'm gonna go ahead and tighten these bolts. We're gonna go ahead and put this bolt in. We're gonna go with the knee and make sure the bolts are put in here. So this gentleman's bracket right here is bent, so we're just gonna contour the defender to adjust for that. So it's a little bit bent back. So let's see if we can get this fender in. right, the next step, I'm gonna go ahead and pull this back. I'm gonna find this bracket right here. And put that bolt. You just hand tighten it. Fender, I don't like how it's lined up. So I need to push back on it. I'm gonna adjust it. So pretty much you're gonna adjust it from back there. So now it's lined up properly. And then you're gonna tighten up that back bolt. So I'm gonna push it down and I'm gonna tighten up the back. Flush right here. So I'm gonna pull back right here. So right here, I don't like how it's flush. It's not that flush. So I'm gonna unscrew these bolts and pull back a little bit. Think the alignment is good, open the door and make sure that it's not hitting anything. Okay. The next step is going to be putting this bolt back in. So we're gonna put this bolt back in. Just like that. Tighten this one up. That's good. Tighten up the back bolt. We can put this black piece back in. So just have to clip it with these, line it up. So I like to insert first. And then push down on it until you hear that click. And that means that it's in. There you go. And don't forget this silicone rubber piece that covers this piece right here. All right, so that's good to go. The fender liner goes over the fender. So this one's cushioned a little bit. We cushion back out. We start putting everything back together. I'm gonna go ahead and put the bolts back on this bracket. The longer bolt goes in the back, in the front, I mean. So go ahead and tighten that up. That's tight. That one looks like a screw. That's tight. Alright, so we got one last bolt that goes underneath the window right here. This piece right here, push it back, and it should line up right here. Like that. Take this piece. Back into it. Okay. I'm gonna go ahead and put these pieces back in. One right here. One right here. Don't forget to put this in here because it'll make the bumper fall off. So insert in there and push. And then underneath, make sure this is underneath the car. Like that. Another one right here. All right, the last piece of the puzzle, open the door. Well, second to the last piece of the puzzle, open the door, put this back in, just push down on it, take the tape off. We got this one last piece right here. Put this back in, slide underneath first. Push down. There you go. Hey guys, so that's how you guys install a 2014 Toyota Corolla passenger side fender. If you guys like this video, go ahead and hit that like button, subscribe to us, and also turn on that push notification so you can see more of our videos. All these parts that you see here, you can also buy on our website, www.revmoto.com. Thank you guys for watching.